Welcome to International Securities Exchange's podcast series. Facilitated by renowned educators, ISE podcasts are intended to teach beginning as well as seasoned investors the ins and outs of trading. To find an updated list of podcasts, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts. Please be sure to listen to our important message following this episode regarding the risks of investing in exchange-traded options.
This is my training tool. So I will make analysis on first of all on euro dollar. With taker is EUU on the IEC exchange. As you can see, the previous time I hosted a presentation for you, I was bearish on the euro against dollar. I was we were at Trading Central long US dollar since December the last year, December 2009, and we were true, but we believe that the long US dollar trend is weakening, and maybe there are some opportunities to reverse the position, and maybe the trend will go up. So in this example, we can see this bearish channel is no more relevant. We can draw this kind of figure, which is a declining trend line, and as you can see, the price is approaching very quickly this declining trend line. You can also notice a bullish divergence on the RSI technical indicator. You can see here you have this divergence with a new low on the euro dollar, which is not a new low on the RSI indicator. So maybe we can stay short for the moment, but with a very tight stop loss level. I will say 127.5, and once this or if this level is broken up, then I believe this is a very nice opportunity to enter a long position on the euro dollar with a first target, as you can see here, at 132.50. The next target is set at 138, and then 132. This new uptrend will be invalidated in case of a break of the 125 level. So here is to sum up, in case of a break of 127.50, you can, I believe, buy euro dollar with a high level of conviction. Let's turn to the British pound. I've sent a trade alert on the British pound on the FX options website and in your mail if you are clients. The IEC ticker is GBP for the cable. GBP British pound against US dollar. As you can see, you have here a very nice bearish channel, and the underlying has broken up the upper boundary of the bearish channel, which is not yet the case, for example, on the euro dollar. So that's why I recommended to buy this pair with a first target at 166. and the second target at 162. This stop loss is also very tight at 149. Maybe we can have some pullback on this kind of breakout, as we've seen before, when a level is broken up or broken down, the underlying is accelerating, but a pullback may occur. So you can take advantage of any pullback to enter new long positions. Now let's have a look on the Japanese yen, US dollar against Japanese yen. The outlook is more blurry or mixed on the Japanese yen, because as you can see, we have a nice horizontal trading range. This is the first case we've seen at the beginning of the presentation. You can see here, this is ranging horizontally. So maybe we can buy when the price is at the bottom of the range, and sell when the price is at the top of the range. So in this case, we've just reached the bottom of the trading range. So a nice opportunity is to buy at this level with a tight stop loss, for example at 87. 87 is a very nice level, stop loss level, because one, if you break below this level, it should become really bearish. Really bearish. So first target is set at 90. 90, as you can see, this is a nice intermediary resistance, and the second intermediary resistance is set at 92, and the third, but very strong resistance, in my opinion, is 95. 95, which is the previous high, and you can see here, and a very nice level, because prices have touched these levels many times in the past. Let's have a look on the some exotic pairs. For example, the US dollar against the Canadian dollar. CDD as a IAC ticker. So as you can see here, CDD has struck against its resistance level at 150, and this is it was a very nice level to enter short position on the US dollar again. Next target is set at 101.40, as you can see here, which is the previous low of the of this short-term bullish trend.
Thank you for listening to our podcast. To find more podcasts on options, stocks, alternative markets, and market data, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts.